Let me take it back outside, see if we can see some of that sunshine on our HD cam. Oh, yeah, that's nice. We got I-4 westbound and eastbound dry. That's great news for motorists as we are in the heart of rush hour right now. And as we take a look at the first alert update on Debbie, post-tropical Debbie now. What does that mean? That means it no longer has any tropical characteristics, and it is moving away quickly now off towards the east at about 13 miles. And wind gusts are still with us, especially along the east side of the peninsula as it's pulling away. And some parting shots. This is now roughly 140 miles due east of the Kennedy Space Center. Let's zoom it on in here and kind of put this into perspective. There's the last parting shots of shower activity now pulling away from Cocoa Beach. A few showers here over towards Melbourne, over towards Palm Bay, Grant, Valcaria, Mico, over down towards Sebastian. But the big story again, weather watchers, a huge help to us. Thank you so much, Bob in Ocala. Nearly 20 inches of rain. That's his all-time monthly record for the month of June. Mike, 9.7. Betsy in the Villages, nearly 11 inches of rain. And you take a look now, June rainfall for Orlando, 9.64 inches. We typically average for the month of June, 9.78. Nowhere near, though, that record of 18-plus inches of rain. And with all of the rain the last couple of days, just one lone active brush fire right now, just north of Sam Sula. So it's good to see a fire count with just one, considering where we've been over the last couple of months. Afternoon highs creeping up to near 90 south and west of Orlando. Gusty northwest winds continuing this evening, but it's going to feel mighty nice out there. We were in the mid-70s the last couple of mornings. We're dropping into the upper 60s and lower 70s, especially north and west of Orlando. It's going to feel like a cold front has come on through. In fact, near record lows. If anybody's got a chance at it, Daytona Beach, the record low for tomorrow, 67. We're forecasting 69. Bye-bye, Debbie. Hello, sunshine. And here comes the heat, too, by the way, with this big ridge of high pressure building on in. Westerly flow typically means we're in the mid-90s, and even on Sunday, if you're looking for some shower activity, best chance to be down towards Miami. The news for the boaters, though, is still some dangerous currents out there. We'll have to watch this developing angle rather closely now over the next couple of days. Looks like marine conditions will improve over the weekend. So let's spell it out. 74, 86, 90, back into the low 90s for your Thursday afternoon. And then as we flip the page here, head on into Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. 94, feeling more like the upper 90s. Jim and Martha, as we head into the weekend, it feels like temperatures are around 100 degrees, slow down, take it easy, and drink that water.